Friends, today I'm going to share a different approach, which is a postulate approach for the fixation of the lacking condyle humerus fracture in children. 4-year male old child fell from a height before 1 month. He was primarily treated by a native doctor, we call them bone setter. He presented to us with swelling, pain, and restriction of movement. State that the same approach may be used for fresh fracture and non-union. This child presented with a lateral prominence and movement restrictions. His AP, lateral and internal oblique presentation X-ray showed strong type 5 fracture or type 3 Jacobs fracture with a flipped and rotated fragment. You start the surgery in lateral position, palpate the lateral bump, then take a posterior incision which is slightly curved on the lateral side till the apex of the lateral condyle fragment and come back to the olecranon. After the incision and hemostasis, the first thing you need to do is to raise the flap. The first flap we raise is on the lateral side to reach the outermost aspect of the lateral condylar fragment. Once the flaps are raised, the second thing we do is to erase the lateral border of triceps from the humerus as well as lift it from the elbow joint capsule. This will take a few minutes. A knee dissection will help in hemostasis as well as delineation of the fracture fragments in a better way. Here, I am incising the part of the triceps on elbow joint. Subperiosteal dissection of the metaphyseal part is then done. And exposure is aided by placing a bone spike in the over the proximal fragment. Having done that, the second thing is you delineate the fracture fragment by palpating. In non-union and late presenting case, there may be some fibrosis in between, and we start by incising the fibrosis between the metaphyseal side of the fragment and the fracture fragment. Once the metaphyseal side is inside, the second thing is you open the joint capsule over the fracture fragment. Do not touch any attachment to the lateral condylar fragment. Fibrosis between the articular surface and the lateral condylar fragment should be incised with cautery. Once that is done, a blunt dissection between the metaphyseal side of the fracture and the rotated fragment is separated by hemostasis with a hemostat and a cautery forceps. To have a better alignment, it is a good idea to separate the metaphyseal fragment on anterior as well as posterior side. The fragment which is rotated and flipped outside, the rotation of the fragment is then corrected. If it is not possible to correct it manually in a delayed presenting case, some soft tissue dissection between the lateral condyle and subcutaneous plane may be required. If there is any intra-articular fibrosis, at this stage should be removed. And to confirm the articular alignment, further dissection to expose the medial joint line is carried out. Once the fragment is rotated, to manipulate the fragment in a better way, we use a joystick. Here, I'm trying to coax the fragment without the use of joystick, which is a quite difficult thing to do when the patient presents late or in a case where there is a fracture non-union. Inserting a joystick helps you in aligning the fragment and remaining away from the fragment with an easy manipulation. Make it sure that the joystick comes just above the articular cartilage so that the same joystick can be advanced to fix as a horizontal keyboard, which I will show you a little later. If the proximal fragment control is required, a wound clamp or a key wire could be used and should be used as a joystick. Having to control of both the segments, intra-articular part of the fracture should be aligned with the joystick, help of the joystick. Here it is advisable to spend maximum time to get good intra-articular alignment. An intra-articular alignment check may require some hard retraction of the polyacrylon which is present on the posterior side. Once a reasonably good articular alignment is achieved and is visualized by placing a dura forceps, first fixation is done by a K-wire which starts from the epiphyseal part of the fragment. Once the biparticle fixation is achieved, the drill is removed and IITV check is done. Here you can see one K-wire which is fixing the fracture fragment and a second joystick K-wire. At this stage, the joystick K-wire should be advanced into medial condyle of fragment to give an extra fixation. The length of the wire can be checked by palpating, and after this, the second K wire is passed from the metaphyseal fragment of the lateral condylar fragment. The same wire is just to create a track for the 4 mm cannulated cancellous screw which we are going to use for fixation. Once the K wire is in place after a biparticle purchase, an IITV check is done to know the correct position of the wire. Here you can see that second K-wire fixing the metaphyseal part of the fragment over which we are going to pass the screw. After confirming the position of the K-wire, measurement of the screw size is taken with help of cylinder-sized K-wire. After this, the K-wire is removed and the same K-wire is replaced by guide pin of 4 mm cannulated cancellous screw. After passing the guide pin, it is a good idea to confirm that it is in the track which we have desired. But after IITV confirmation, 4 mm cannulated cancellous screw is driven over the guide pin without drilling, because generally the fragments are osteoporotic in such situation and does not require any drilling. The final compression is then achieved by final few rotations of the screw. After this, a final check is done. And for the further confirmation, an arthrogram is done. I always do arthrography when there is an intra-articular operation of the elbow joint. After the arthrogram, spread the die by moving the joint in a range of movement. Here you can see the articular surface is very well aligned, and you can see the die has trickled over the lateral condylar fragment, which is now very well delineated as shown by this dotted green line. Having confirmed good articular alignment, we proceed towards closure by bending and cutting the extra K-wire. All the K-wires in this surgery are buried. Not a single K-wire is kept out, because here we wish to keep the implant for a longer period of time. The same would be true in surgery for the non-union of lateral condyle fractures. At this stage, you may remove the tourniquet, achieve hemostasis, and then do a layered closure. The wires are then cut, bent, and first the triceps is closed over the proximal part, covering all the implants, and then the elbow joint capsule is also covered. It is a good idea at this stage that all the implants are very well covered by the soft tissue so that there is no prominence which hinders you in a post-operative period. After closure of the joint capsule, the last thing you close is subcutaneous layer. After subcutaneous layer closure, the final closure is then done by subcuticular stitches. The child is post-operatively immobilized in above the knee, above the elbow plaster for 6 weeks. Let's look at a representative case. Five-year-old female presented to us with 1-year-old injury. She was also treated by native doctors and she had concerns of movement restriction, inability to lift weight, activity-related pain. This is how she presented to us, with minor deformity and mild restriction of terminal restriction of flexion on the right side. Her x-ray showed again type 5 some injury with frank non-union. You can have a look at the comparative view of the left side. She presented to us with CT scan, which in my opinion has a very limited value in preoperative planning of this fracture and may be avoided to save us some cost. This is the 3D rendering of the same child which was provided to us by the radiologist. I'm not sure this 3D rendering with a single fragment will be how much useful in planning this surgery. She had a primary fixation like a similar case with 1K horizontal and 1 oblique KY. This is her final fixation and arthrographic confirmation. Note there is a reasonably good alignment but not normal. I have used locally harvested bone graft from the metafacial area of the left distal humerus. I haven't used any screw. All wires were buried. This is her 6 months follow-up, showing good union in AP, lateral as well as internal oblique views. At 6 months, she had removal of implant after excellent functional recovery without any deformity. I would like to specially thank our ever faithful patients, my staff at Rainbow Hospital and my resident doctors at Shalgarin Hospital and Mitchell Institute of Medical College. Thank you very much, viewers, for watching this video and subscribing me in a huge number. For any query, do contact us on this phone number.